We've talked a lot about the impact of the cold economic war on various sectors, but one we haven't touched on yet is the trucking industry, which plays a critical role in getting both imported and exported goods where they need to go. So we sent Frank Holland to Aston, Pennsylvania.
Keep on trucking is a popular saying, but this year, the only thing truckers are saying is that revenues are declining.
2019 has been a challenge.
Mark Zimmerman is a third-generation trucker. The portion of his business under contract has remained fairly steady. But the daily rates for trucking, known as the spot market, have seen declines since the tariffs went into effect last year. Retailers and manufacturers front-loaded shipments into the U.S. at the end of 2018 to get ahead of those tariffs. Now, their warehouses and stock rooms are full, and those companies are in the driver's seat.
They say, I don't have to move it right now. I'm going to negotiate a rate that's a little bit lower than what I thought I was going to pay initially. And the trucker then is saying, okay, if I want to move that load, I have to be willing to negotiate and come up with a lower rate.
With the shippers having the pricing power at this time, it definitely has an effect on our lower revenue. And it's also dropping to our bottom line, where we don't have the ability to increase as our costs increase for 2019.
The rates for standard trucks have fallen 19% since last April. For refrigerated trucks that carry food, nearly 14%. Flatbed rates for industrial goods are down about the same amount. The impact felt by Zimmerman and big names like J.B. Hunt, Schneider National, and Knight Swift, all reporting lower revenues this year, all seeing their stock price drop double digits over the past year.
Lower U.S. exports are also hurting trucking margins. When drivers of this Pennsylvania company drop off a trailer like this one and pick up another at the same time and at the same place, it's called a dual transaction. It's more profitable, but trucking companies say it's happening less and less at major ports.
We've seen dual transactions fall over the last 5 years from anywhere from an 80 or 85% normal to under 20% across the board.
There is hope that a trade deal can reverse this trend as the industry seeks new roads to revenues. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Frank Holland in Aston, Pennsylvania.